Actually, I went to almost every star with that film to play Maqbool. Almost every star, I think, except Amir and Shah Rukh and Salman. I went to everyone, and once when Amir saw the film, the first question he asked me, why did you come to me with this role? So I said that I went to everyone else. But sabne mana kiya, disheartened kiya. Aur kisi ne bola ki, are hero loser hai isme. To maine kaha Shakespeare ka Macbeth hai, to main kya karunga isme loser. When I didn't play for my college and I was disheartened, so I met Rekha and a lot of other musicians in college, and you know, I drifted from cricket to music, and that's where I had some music in my system, and because my father was a poet, so slowly I developed you know, and I knew that I can be a composer. And to be honest, I wanted success at any rate, at any cost. So, and I thought that music composing would be the fastest for me. So, I started feeling very suffocated in just doing music, because the kind of films were being made, and the kind of films, more than were being made, the kind of films I was offered, I was not happy with them, and Gulda Sahib saw my frustration, and he told me that if you really want to you know, follow your own things and do your own thing, then you have to become director, because this is the medium of director.
So when did you fall in love with Shakespeare?
Accidentally. Yeah.
Like all good things in life.
Yeah. Because I made Makdi, and like every filmmaker, I wanted to make a film in gangster genre. And I was looking for a story which goes beyond gang wars, and which can, you know, scratch some layers of, you know, human nature and human conflict, which goes beyond bullets, guns, and dead bodies. We have a godson. His name is Ala. वो देहरादून में पढ़ रहा था. तो मैं उसके साथ ट्रेन में आ रहा था. तो तीन चार घंटे की जर्नी थी शताब्दी एक्सप्रेस. तो I was getting bored. So I said कि कोई अपनी कोई स्टोरी की बुक निकाल के दे इसमें से. तो उसने वो लैंप की जो वो एवरेज वर्जन होता है दिया. तो उसमें पहली स्टोरी मैंने मैकबेथ पढ़ी. और मैकबेथ पढ़ते ही मुझे एक तो कुरोसावा का पूरी फिल्म एकदम दिमाग में घूमी मेरे. एंड द सेकंड थिंग आई सॉ दैट इट कैन बी अ वेरी गुड स्टोरी और रेस फॉर अ गैंगस्टर फिल्म. So he said that I got angry, why man has a right to kill, I will make my woman kill seven husbands. So he wrote that short story, and then he gave me the reference. So I went back and I read that story. I watched that film, it's a black and white film, very old film. So I said, Ruskin Sahib, it was like a 6-7 pages story. And you could see his, you know, wicked sense of humor in that short story. Uska jo climax tha, wo usmein Ruskin Sahib ka alag tha. And then, you know, my co-writer Matthew Robbins, he's a Christian and he's American. And when we were just discussing, and we came to know that, you know, when you become nun, you become, you know, Christ bride. So I thought that this should be our climax, you know. That should be the seventh murder. The husband is already dead. So that's how it came. And again, Ruskin Sahib said, yeah, it's brilliant, you should keep this ending. एक तो उसमें आई थिंक वो जो कहावत है इग्नोरेंस इज ब्लेस, यू नो, वो एक वाली बात थी कि मुझे पता नहीं था कि मैं किस जगह हाथ डाल रहा हूँ. मुझे नहीं पता था शेक्सपियर का ओहदा किस लेवल का. मुझे अपने कंट्री के जो हालात थे, और बार बार जिससे भी मिलता था, जैसे मनमोहन शेट्टी जी, इज सच ए इवॉल्व पर्सन, यू नो, मनमोहन जी, जब वो मार्केट को देख के बात बोलते थे, तो मुझे लगता था कि यहाँ किसी को कोई फर्क ही नहीं पड़ेगा, मैं कुछ भी करूँ शेक्सपियर के साथ. तो मैं थोड़ा फियरलेस था कि किसी को कोई मतलब ही नहीं है, तो यहाँ पे क्या है, इसको चेंज करते चलो. जैसे